Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about tuples. Tuples are very similar to lists. Lists are enclosed in brackets. Tuples are enclosed in parentheses. X is a tuple. The elements can be of different data types. This tuple has a float number, 2.7, a string, hello world, and an integer number, negative 3. The length of the tuple is 3 because it contains 3 elements. The type of X is indeed a tuple. A tuple can contain another tuple. This is a nested tuple because this element is a tuple of 2 elements. The length of Y is 4. The plus sign means concatenation. In this example, we join 2 tuples together. The result is a tuple of 4 elements. The star means repetition. In this example, we repeat this tuple 3 times. The result is a tuple of 6 elements. The indexing and slicing of tuples are similar to strings and lists. Tuple indexes start with 0. For this tuple y, y1 means first element, which is hello. y3 means the third element, which is this inner tuple. If we want to access the value negative 7, which is the zeroth element in the inner tuple, we use the nested indexing, like this, y30. This is an example of tuple slicing. We try to access the elements starting from 1, going up to 3, including 1, but not including 3. The result is hello and 4. Tuples are useful in many ways. Let's define a tuple days, which contains the abbreviations of Monday through Sunday. We can access the abbreviation of the nth day using days n-1 because the index starts from 0. We can also use a for loop to print out all the abbreviations in the tuple. If we want to return both the index and the value in the tuple, we can use the enumerate function. The index will be given to I, and the value will be given to D. We assemble these pieces of information in this way. Day, I plus 1, is the abbreviation. The output is day 1 is Monday, day 2 is Tuesday, and so on. In this statement, the in keyword will check whether Monday is an element of the tuple days. The answer is true. However, the lowercase Monday is not an element of days. The answer is false. Similarly, 5 is not in this tuple, so the answer is false. For a complex variable like this, we can tell whether it is a list or a tuple by checking the outermost symbols. In this case, the outermost symbols are a pair of brackets, so it's a list. The zeroth element is a string. The first element is a tuple, and the second element is a list. Of course, we can also use the type function to do the checking. Yes, it is a list. This, however, is a tuple, because outermost symbols are parentheses. Checking it using the type function, we get the same answer. The second element of this tuple is a list, 3 and 5. Remember, the index always starts with 0 in Python. There is another way to define a tuple. We can drop the parentheses and only use a sequence of variables separated by commas, like this. The output shows that this X is a tuple. It is required to include a comma when create a tuple with only one element, like this example, 2 and a comma. A pair of parentheses is automatically added to mark this is a tuple. It may look strange at first, but you will get used to it later. We can add the parentheses by ourselves, like this. Use the type function to check it. It's a tuple. If we forgot the comma, we are defining a number, not a tuple. For example, x equals 2, no comma, or even x equals 2 with a pair of parentheses, still no comma. The type is integer. To define an empty tuple, we need a pair of empty parentheses. This type function shows this is the tuple. We shouldn't write it this way. This is not the right way to define an empty tuple. It will produce a syntax error. Unlike lists, tuples are immutable. We cannot change its elements after it's defined. Why is a tuple that contains two numbers, 2 and 3? If we try to change the zeroth element of y to 1 like this, we will see an error. Tuple object doesn't support item assignment. We already have lists. Why do we need tuples in Python? It turns out Python uses tuples for simultaneous assignment and unpacking multiple returns from functions. This statement is a simultaneous assignment. 1 will be assigned to x, and 2 will be assigned to y. The right-hand side is actually a tuple. This is another example. We split this date, May 20th, 2019, into three parts using the slash symbol. These three parts are returned from the split function. They are unpacked and given to month, day, and year respectively. Okay, that was all about tuples. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.